गुड मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रन एंड वेलकम टू ऑल ऑफ यू इन ऑनलाइन क्लासेस। डियर स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू टीच यू वन ऑफ द इम्पॉर्टेंट राइटिंग पोर्शंस, दैट इज अ लेटर टू एडिटर विथ वन ऑफ द एग्जाम्पल। डियर स्टूडेंट्स, इन previous videos also I have told you about this letter to editor, and in that I have told you and taught you how a letter to editor is written, what is the actual format of writing a letter to editor, what methods you have to follow. I have explained in details, even I have given you many questions regarding that. Today on one of the important issue, dear students, I am going to teach you this letter to editor. Dear students, as you know, whenever you are going to write a letter to editor, first of all you have to write the sender's address at the top. Suppose sender's address is 229 Seema Puri, New Delhi. After writing the sender's address in detail, then you have to leave one line and then you have to write date. Or date you have to write like 22nd August 2020 or August 22, 2020. You will not write that 22/8/2020 or 22.8.2020, because that is the wrong method, or you have to write the correct format. Dear students, and after writing the date, then you have to write the sender's receiver's address, or that is the editor, the Times of India, New Delhi. After that, then you have to write salutation. It can be written after the subject or it can be written before the subject. In this question I have written before the subject, but both are correct. After the subject you can write sir, or before the subject you can write. In some books it is given after the subject, or in some books it is given before the subject. Or then whatever issue you are writing the letter to editor, that you have to write need to improve the living condition in slum, or after that you have to write the body of the letter. In that some lines you have to write in such way, suppose through the columns of your esteemed newspaper I would like to attract the attention of general public as well as concerned authorities towards the major issue, miserable condition of slums. And after that you have to add some more points, and lastly you have to write yours truly, Ramesh Kumar. So it was all about the format and how you will write this letter to editor. I am reading one questions. Ki lack of job opportunities in the rural areas is forcing people to migrate to cities. Every big city thus has a number of slums in it. Our life in these slums is miserable. Write a letter टू एडिटर इन 120 टू 150 वर्ड्स ऑफ ए नेशनल न्यूज़पेपर ऑन हाउ यू कैन इम्प्रूव द लिविंग कंडीशन इन दी स्लम्स, यू आर रमेश कुमार ऑफ 229 सीमापुरी न्यू दिल्ली. दिस इज द क्वेश्चन. सो एज आई हैव टोल्ड यू डियर चिल्ड्रन कि फर्स्ट यू हैव टू राइट द एड्रेस ऑफ सेंडर ऑफ मिस्टर रमेश कुमार और हिज एड्रेस इज 229 सीमापुरी न्यू दिल्ली एंड देन यू हैव टू राइट द डेट एंड देन एड्रेस ऑफ रिसीवर और आफ्टर दैट सैल्यूटेशन एंड देन सब्जेक्ट और आफ्टर दैट देन बॉडी ऑफ द लेटर और थ्रू इन दैट यू विल स्टार्ट कि थ्रू द कॉलम्स ऑफ योर स्टीम न्यूज़पेपर आई वुड लाइक टू अट्रैक्ट द अटेंशन ऑफ जनरल पब्लिक एज वेल एज कंसर्न्ड अथॉरिटीज टुवर्ड्स द मेजर इशू मिजरेबल कंडीशन ऑफ स्लम्स. As we know that India is a developing country or it is making a huge progress in every field. However, the mushrooming slums in the city provide an altogether different scenario. Though our country is a developing country and it is making a lot of progress in the different fields, but the condition of slums is not satisfactory. Or we know that a country depends on its people. If the people of the country are not in good situation and not in good condition, then country can never be a powerful country, a powerful nation, and a developed country. Dear students, in our country, the pressure in slum areas is increasing day by day. It is because of many reasons, due to unemployment, due to illiteracy. We know this thing also, that in rural areas many people are homeless, many people are landless, they have no job opportunities in the village areas, in the rural areas. So for the survival they migrate from village to city and they come to city in search of job. But as we know that the people, those who migrate from village to city, they are not educated, they are not qualified, so they don't get the job easily in cities. Or finally, dear children, they are forced to live in jhuggi jhopadis, they are forced to live in such slum areas where the condition is very, very miserable. Even there is not proper sanitation there, not proper cleanliness there, dear children. And due to this, sometimes they suffer from many diseases also. Due to this unhygienic situation, due to bad condition of these areas. Not only this much, due to lack of job and due to lack of money, many times it happen, dear children, that the people, those who are living in slum areas or in slums, they are forced to sleep empty stomach because they don't have money, they don't have any employment, they don't have any resource. So and government is also not in position to provide and fulfill their basic necessities such as food, cloth and shelter. Though our Indian government is claiming that it is making houses for homeless people, landless people, but the people, those who are living in slum areas, uneducated and illiterate, they are unaware about that. They are not getting such facilities. Or if any homeless person, if landless person of slum area or rural areas, if those who live in either in city areas, if anybody gets such facilities by the government, to for that he has to face a lot of problems. Firstly, he is exploited by the system. Firstly, he has to face the corruption, or after face struggling a lot, then he gets the houses given by the government. But as we know, that person is uneducated, that person is unemployed, so for his survival he gives his that house which he has got from the government on rent, because he thinks that he will get some money. So dear children, in hope of that, he gives his house on rent. But you cannot say all the people, those who are homeless and landless, they are getting all these facilities provided by the government, some people. Or they are also not able to live there because they don't have money. So what is the question, what is important issue? The government should provide houses to them, or it should also take care of their basic necessities. It government should suppose open some factories, set up some factories in the rural areas, in the slum areas, and should provide job to them, should provide work to them, so that they can survive, so that they can live safely and easily. Or if these things will be provided by the government, then automatically the life of these people, those who are living in slum areas, their condition will be better. Or moreover, these people must be educated also, because in lack of education they are exploited by the system. So the people also and their children also, they must be educated. Or if they will be educated, their children will be educated, so they can be self-dependent, they can get the job. Or government should provide all these things. If otherwise, our country can never be a developed nation, because human resource is one of the important resource. Or if we are not able to provide, if the system and government is not able to provide them proper facilities, प्रॉपर हाउस, प्रॉपर एजुकेशन, प्रॉपर मेडिसिन, देन हाउ द कंट्री विल बी अ डेवलप्ड कंट्री एंड हाउ दोज पीपल विल कंट्रीब्यूट इन द डेवलपमेंट ऑफ नेशन. सो इफ ऑल दीज मेजर्स विल बी टेकन, तो ऑब्वियसली द कंडीशन इन स्लम एरियाज एंड सिचुएशन इन स्लम एरियाज विल बी इम्प्रूव्ड एंड द पीपल दोज हु आर लिविंग इन सच एरियाज देयर लिविंग स्टैंडर्ड विल ऑल्सो बी इम्प्रूव्ड. एंड लास्टली यू हैव टू राइट डियर चिल्ड्रेन योर्स ट्रूली रमेश कुमार. आई होप यू हैव अंडरस्टूड एंड यू विल राइट दिस लेटर टू एडिटर इन योर नोटबुक ऑल्सो. थैंक यू डियर चिल्ड्रेन.